Hello all. A very good evening to one and all. Do drop me a hi if you're logging in so that I will know. Am I audible? Yeah, hi. Hi everyone. Hi Asa ma'am. Hi Preeti. Okay. Yeah, so I'm audible. So good evening all. Hope everyone is safe at home. I welcome you all on behalf of Mrs. Deva, Women Entrepreneurs Community, to the session. Okay. First, thank you Asa ma'am for giving me this opportunity to talk on your platform. I would like to say a few words about Asta Jain. She is the founder of Mrs. Deva Group. She is a wonderful person. She is an excellent business coach. She always supports everyone out there. She actually understands the needs of the clients, and that's what is her strength itself. She is also a work from home expert, helps housewives and moms become financially independent. Thank you Asta ma'am for giving me this opportunity. Yes, hi Preeti, hi Ratna. I am Dr. Gayatri. I am the founder of Flourishing Kids Chennai. I work with kids having learning challenges. I also conduct awareness sessions for parents and teachers. I strongly believe that awareness is very, very important. 1 in 10 children have a learning challenge, and it's high time we address that. So let me start our today's session. How to build attention skills. So before going to the topic, let me ask you a simple question. When we were in our school times, do you remember how much would be our class period, class session? You can type in just how many minutes it would be. 30 minutes, 45 minutes, 1 hour. Do you all remember that? We used to have 7 to 8 periods, and we all have a timetable for that. There would be sessions, there would be classes, and we actually arrange everything accordingly. We take our classwork notes, homework notes, everything. Yes. Yes, Preeti, 45 minutes. Yes, it was 45 minutes, around 45 minutes. Yeah. Yeah, that was our usual time, right? Why do you think? Yeah, Asa ma'am is also typing. It was 40 minutes. Why do you think it was only 40 to 45 minutes? Why not? It could be like morning 2 hours complete English, then afternoon 2 hours complete max. No, it was not that way. Yes, I am getting many responses. Manisha is saying 30 minutes. Yeah, we used to have only that long sessions. 30 to 45 minutes on an average. We are not having 2 hours, 3 hours long classes. Yes, that's correct. Grasping power, our attention. There is a span. It's called our attention span. So every one of us have an attention span, and we can't take in more than that. We can take in, but there are many factors if we have to sustain it for long also. Okay. So what actually, is there any specific time or there is a time limit till that time we can be able to concentrate, we can concentrate complete 100%? I will give you a range. I will let you know why I am giving this range. Just last week a mom called me and she asked me, my kid is not at all sitting in class or not at all interested in writing homework. I am just giving her only 45 minutes to write and she is not doing. And I asked her, what age is your kid? Her kid is 4.5 years old. So for a 4.5 years old, 45 minutes is a very long stretch of time. It is really long. Kid cannot sit. Maybe we think that once the 45 minutes is over, kid's homework is completed and then they can go out and play or then they can do anything else. But 45 minutes is a long stretch of time. So I'll let you know how much is the general average time. Just take this simple thing. If your kid's age is 3 years, multiplied by 3 times, 9 minutes. Around 9 minutes is the time where a kid can completely be attentive and be on one task. 9 is an average minute. Some kids, there is a range. They can sit for a long time. Some kids, they will sit for a shorter time. So this is the time. If your kid is 5 years old, 15 minutes. Around 15 minutes, you have to plan the tasks. So for a 15-year-old kid, approximately I am saying 15, 16 years old kid who is in 10th standard, for them itself, it is only 30 minutes. So just think, if a 10th standard kid can sit for 30 minutes or a max to 45 minutes only, we are expecting our small kids who are only 4 or 5 to sit for 45 minutes. So this is what is the main thing for attention span. So how to build activities so that our kids' attention is gradually rising and increasing and they are getting focused on the activities. So there is one more thing. If we like the activity, we do it for a longer time. This is not for a child or an adult. Suppose we like to do that activity. If we do a craft, if I'm interested in doing a craft, if I'm interested in reading a book, I can sustain it for 2 hours also. But if you don't like that activity and you're not ready to do it, you won't be able to sustain your attention for a longer period of time. So this works for kids also. If the kid is having interest and they like to do it, definitely they'll do it for longer time. Next, we have to see the time of the day. For kids is very, very important. Whether it is morning, afternoon, during their nap time or just before to bed, we have to actually focus which time our kid would be attentive. So some kids would be attentive as soon as they get up. As soon as they wake up in the morning, they are much more attentive. For some kids, they need a little time. They need a little time. Yeah. Yes, Preeti, it's very difficult to manage my 6-year twins to sit in front of online class. Yes, it's very difficult. For a 6-year-old kid, 3 hours is a longer span. So it is little difficult, and because of this online times also, there are things changing over, and we have to address that also. So plan tasks, activities when your kid is more attentive. Then one more important thing, check whether the kid is hungry or your kid is actually tired. Maybe sometimes they are hungry, they wouldn't have had a proper regular breakfast, a complete breakfast or something, they wouldn't be interested that day. So don't plan an intense activity when your kid is already tired or already is hungry. If possible, give a snack so that they can sit, they can have a snack, and then they slowly relax down, and then we start an activity. So the 3 main things for attention span is, it depends on the time of the day when your kid is attentive. It also depends whether your kid is actually interested in the activity, whether they are enjoying the activity. Then, is your kid hungry, tired, or something else also? Something, they are not in the mood for writing because they already have their friends playing over, or they want to do some other activities. So there are multiple activities also. So look at these. Thank you all for joining in. I will try to address as many as possible. Please ask questions and comments in the session. I will try to answer as much as possible. Okay. So these are the main things. Today we are going to discuss about sustained attention. What is sustained attention? When your child can attend and focus on a task for a continuous stretch of time. It's time. It's continuous stretch of time, and they are attentive also. When they can do it for a longer time, it is called sustained attention. So I'll be giving some activities where we can actually focus on sustained activities for kids. Now we will start with younger group. with the little ones. So if the kid is around 6 months, hi Manisha, hi Monas, hi Bina, thank you all for joining in. So if the kid is 6 months, that is younger kid, the kid is only around 6 months. So for those kids, how will the attention be? Would the kids be able to be independently attentive? They can focus on a skill or activity. For those kids, it is always a joint attention. A mom or a caretaker, mom, dad or a grandparent or a caretaker, child and a thing. These three form sustained attention. How to manage during this time, kids' whole time is getting consumed by online classes. Yes, Manisha, that's a very valid question. I can understand that now the online classes are getting the whole time. It is taking up their whole mornings or the whole days. See, now the time is very different and classes are getting on online. But when evening we are giving them to write their assignments or homeworks, that time I will give you some tips how to make them sit and write. I'll be covering that at the end of the session so that I'll be answering your question also there. But for the online classes, if possible, give them a break. If they can stand up also for 5 minutes, if they can stand and listen to the class, or they can just actually move the chair and use a different chair, just try these things so that kid will be little more attentive. It's difficult to sustain for longer sessions, but because of these online classes, it's like that. And we have to see that kid takes little breaks in between the classes also. Like I said, they can just get up, they can just sit in a different chair, you could just change the height of the chair or anything, so that it will be like little interesting and little different for the kids. And have some snacks for them. I think almost all classes they give a break after 45 minute sessions, so give them some snack, give them water, keep them hydrated. These things would be useful in online sessions. So for 6 months kids, we are discussing about the 6 months kid. It's a joint attention. Suppose you are giving them a toy. We give those rattles. You give the rattle, kid can play for 1 minute. But when you are holding the rattle and you are saying, look, this is an orange rattle. Orange, it's orange in color. This is a little more. They're attentive. Okay, I'm hearing some sounds for a new one. Yeah, some sound is coming. Because they're actually grasping the sounds from the outer environment. Some sound. Then they'll look at the toy. They'll see for 1 more minute. So this is how their attention will be increasing. So I'll tell small activities, small practical examples. It depends on your age of the kid, and few kids will start it little early, few kids will start it little later also. The main game is matching game, sorting game. They like to match everything. I know if we have a baby at home, there will be at least 7 to 8 pair of socks or those mittens we'll easily have. Just put them everything together and teach them how to match. Teach them how to match. Which color? Green. We have to just join the green colors. Red colors. Black. Blue. Keep contrasting colors. For smaller kids, keep contrasting. Don't keep purple and blue and ask the kid to identify. It is difficult for them. Keep as much as colorful, as much as bright contrasting colors and ask them to match. And sorting games. Sorting games, they will be definitely having many toys. You could start with their toys itself. Take a big toy. Keep a big toy and then start keeping little smaller, little smaller. They are actually keeping them in an order, or all same shape toys goes into this place. All toys having wheels will go over here. It's like that way. So keep those toys and use those toys to teach them sorting games. This is very main because this is how they learn everything in max and everything in future. So teach them the matching game, sorting games. Just use things which is already available at your home, which already the kid is exposed to, but we haven't taught them as a game. Teach them as a game so that it is useful and they like it. They like to play games, and we can also engage them for at least 4 to 5 minutes. With a toddler, that is a big time, I can know. So next, playing with a ball. Play with a ball. ball movements that teaches them. They have to be concentrate completely on the ball. They have to see where the ball is going, then they have to take it. For smaller kids, just roll the ball. For little bigger kids, you can just throw it. But for smaller kids, rolling the ball and the kid should catch it and they again push it back. So this is a very useful game. The soft balls which comes for smaller kids, it's very useful for making them to be attentive and listen to it more. Next, we can use stringing the beads. The beads, this bigger wooden beads will come and there will be laces with them. So you could just string the beads. You could string the beads on the lace. So this is for again for attention. They have to see correctly where the hole is and then they have to insert the lace into it. For the small kids, you can use bigger beads, and as the age increases, try using smaller beads. Then try using colored beads, beads where actually you say them, put white beads, 5 beads. Kid has to put 5 beads inside. Then blue beads, 5 beads. Then you can say them alternated. Put a white bead, then string a blue bead, white bead, blue bead. So these are all for attention only. The lacing activity is very, very helpful. The lace and beads, or the lacing on a simple chart. You can use the normal shoelace. The normal shoelace is available. Just put some holes on a chart and make the lace move up and down. Teach them how to do it. Teach them how to move the lace. So these are all for attention. They have to focus on the hole. They have to take their small little hands and move the lace up and down over the lacings. Then coloring. Coloring within a boundary is a very, very useful and interesting task for kids. Coloring within a boundary. Coloring, don't start straight away with the regular crayons. Start them with the bigger crayons, big chunk ones. Let them color it. Once as the kid's age increases, teach them how to color within a boundary. Then tracing, to trace something. Teach them how to trace it. You could usually, we can use the small tracing paper available at home, or teach them how you have to trace it so that it appears on the other paper. It's like they have to focus it, then only they can do it. These are all for visual. These are all for visual activities where the kid learns attention more. There are some activities for auditory attention skills. What is it actually, auditory attention? We listen and we grasp. We listen few things and we understand. For a kid, that is very, very important. If they are into the school and the teacher is saying, do this, do that, or as a parent, we teach them, see here, look this, that. So the kid should know if they are hearing something, they are hearing some sound and the words have a meaning, and the meaning they have to interpret it, then they have to do the action. So this is called auditory attention activities. These are very, very useful, and these are like the foundational skills for the kid to go into the next age group where they start reading, writing, everything. What are these auditory activities? A very simple game we all know and we have played as a kid, Simon Says. I think many of you would have heard it. Simon Says. Simon Says, jump. The kid should jump. Simon Says, walk. Simon Says, kick the ball. Everything. Simon Says means the kid understand that, okay, Simon Says, we have to hear and we have to do whatever is our mom or dad is saying. That activity we should do. This is for auditory activity. Yes, Preeti, this is for auditory activities. Then I Spy game. We can play this game anywhere. Anywhere we can play this. At home we can play. If once everything is normal and we are back to normal, when we are going out with a kid, we can just say, I spy with my little eye. You say something what you can see. I spy with my little eye chair. I spy with my little eye clock. The kid should listen to it and they should find it. So this is I Spy game. I Spy game is very, very useful. This I Spy game for little elder kids, you can say with the book itself, with their story book or anything, I spy with my little eye A, and they have to identify where the A letter is. So I Spy game is a very useful game. It's not only simple game, but it also improves their attention for them. Then you can actually say some item, whichever is available at our home. Just say spoon, because kid knows where their spoon and fork or their eating things would be there. Spoon, and the kid should listen to it and they should get it and give to us. You could start with objects only in one room initially, then you could actually expand it to next room also. The kid should go and get it. So for 1 minute, the kid is on the activity continuously. They are thinking that we have to go get it and give it back. So we are improving their attention skill in these activities. Then animal sounds. Animal sounds, we can actually, we can do the sounds for the kids so that the kid can identify the animal. And there are many Google versions, every version out there now. There are sounds available. Just put the sound and there will be a sound coming through your phone or your laptop or anything, and the kid can identify it. It is a very, very nice activity and kids love this activity. It is for their auditory attention skills. Next game is that green light, red light. We know this game. If the kid is running or doing anything, if we say green, they can do it. Red light, stop. Green light, red light. This can be actually done as a both auditory as well as a visual activity. If you want to incorporate visual attention, show them a red light card so that the kid actually stops there. If it is a like auditory activity, just say them, just say, and the kid should listen it, then they stop and move it. So these are all kind of very simple games, and I know many of us play these games, but as we don't know like which age we could start. Yeah, traffic light game. Yes, Preeti, for traffic light game, you could actually start with 1.5 year old kids itself. You could actually start, they understand. If you teach them on a repetition, if you're teaching them again and again, and we model them, always as a parent, model whatever you want to do for a kid or you expect a kid to do. Do model it. This is a very important thing, modeling for a kid. You model it, then the kid will also do the same activity. You could start for 1.5 year kids. 1.5 year old kids can easily understand this game. So next, going to a little bigger kids. I am saying around 3 years kid. 3 years kid is like a preschooler. The preschooler kids are 3 years old. From that age group, how to make them sit and do some activity. I'll just let you know a small easy game. Just grab some 5 things from your home. Just keep it on your desk. Close them with some like a towel or napkin or anything. Just close it. Ask your kid, I'm going to show you 5 things. I'll be showing only for 20 seconds or decide some time according to your kid. Show them. Again, close it. Ask what were the things in that. Just start with basic 3 things for a kid. Just when you're starting always a new activity, keep their favorite objects. Keep their objects like maybe their water bottle, their crayon or something, whichever the kid actually likes it, and it's their own things. Kids love to see their things in a peekaboo fashion. So keep those things, close it and ask them what were the things. Just let them say, let them guess it. You start improving the objects. You start improving from 3, 4, 5. So the kid can actually see it and then they can understand it and remember it. So we are actually improving their attention skills over here. For little bigger kids, the same game, how can we play? For little bigger kids, if you're keeping the same kind of 3 objects or 5 objects, if you're keeping those kind of objects, and what you actually do is, if you are keeping the water bottle, if you have kept the water bottle in a straight position, next time you are actually changing its position, or you are just moving it to the other side, from the left to right or up to down, you are just changing positions. Next you ask your kid, what is this? What object has actually moved over here? Then the kid should identify, okay, this is a water bottle. Water bottle was standing, now the water bottle is sleeping. Yes, so this is how you play games for little bigger kids. Yes, I think Ziba is asking for 11-year-old kid. I'll be coming to 11-year-old kid also. Probably I'll be answering that time, Ziba. I'll be telling for little bigger kids also how to handle it. Yeah, so next, circling the letters. If you're going to teach letters for the kids, you're teaching them alphabets or numbers. We generally start teaching kids even before they start to school itself. So if you're teaching them a new number, you're teaching them today, number 2. Just take a sheet and write numbers. 2, you can write many times 2. Then probably write mix with 3 and 1 randomly. Then you just keep them mixing it. Kids should actually circle the number 2. They can either circle the number 2 or for little smaller kids, just they have to put a sketch mark or something, their colors over the number 2. It is for their concentration. They have to identify among the group which is the number 2. Yeah, so Preeti is asking how to avoid the laptop or mobile screening time. As the classes are going online, the kids use these after the class too. Yes, Preeti. So how to avoid? The best thing I will say is, don't focus on how to avoid or how to minimize the screen time. Focus on activities where actually the kid is engaged so that the screen time or online time is automatically reduced. And one more thing, if you're planning to reduce the screen time, try reducing the time as a whole family together. Just keep like 1 hour or possibly how much ever you can allot in a day. 1 hour the whole family, there is screen free time. That means no one in the family takes a mobile, no one uses a laptop or no one uses any gadget, any TV, anything. So the kid knows there are many activities other than the screen. Why the kids actually watch the screen or something? It is engaging for them. It is interesting for them. It is grasping them. So give activities outside the screen so that kids get interested in outside also. So this is how we have to manage for the kids. Yes. So next is, I was saying the circling the letters or numbers among a group of letters. Next is crossword games. Crosswords are very, very helpful, very useful also. You can start crosswords for small kids, like just start the names which they already know. Just use only the family member's name or the close friend's name or the favorite toy's names. Just use them and put it like a crossword. Then teach them this letter goes to this. You could help with spellings and all. We are just focusing that they have to write it there or they have to understand what game is it and they are trying to fill it in the crossword puzzles. As I was saying already, when you are reading a book, when a kid, you are reading a story time with your book or they themselves have their books from school or their own books. So when you are reading, you could just say, if you have already taught the kid the letter A, you can ask, where all is A there? Where A is there? So wherever A is there, the kid should point it out. That is how you build the skill. You are teaching them to find out, and they should have the print awareness, and that is where we also introduce print awareness, and that is also for an attention strategy. Yeah. So yes, Preeti, yes, I give them time, but they like to take it. Yes, yes, yeah, I can understand. But this is for us, the whole family. Yes, of course, the outing time has reduced, everything is reduced. But just keep one thing in our mind. If suppose we are looking at this situation of this pandemic after some 5 years, you will be actually happy and grateful that you crossed this time. You won't be thinking that your kid was handling the mobile phone on. Anything would change. And everything would change. This time is over. Things will actually change for the kids. It won't be the same. They won't be watching their mobile phones. Now if they are watching a little extra, I will say that it's okay if they are watching for a little more time. Their screen time has exceeded. That's okay. Let us engage in other activities and maybe introduce some books, toys, activities. But that's okay. After some 4 or 5 years, we'll be actually happy that that's okay. My kid and me has crossed this stage. That is what is very, very important in this time. Manisha is asking, but actually at what age they are able to recognize the letters or numbers? Yes, Manisha, it takes time for each kid. It differs. Around 2.5 years to 3 years. That is the time when you already have been showing them the books. Or first, if they are able to recognize the letter or number, first they will be able to identify only the logos or symbols. I always say this example. McDonald's. If they see that symbol, your kid can identify. Yes, they can definitely identify where that symbol is there. Because first is their logographic stage. Then only they go to alphabet stage. Alphabets also, First, always start from the outside environment. Wherever the alphabet is there in the outside, show them on a newspaper, show them on a magazine, show them on some board or anything. Then only you can move on to the books. So it will take time for them to read in actually a book. Yes, before pointing the alphabets in a group, how to make them learn the alphabets, ma'am? Yeah, Anjana, before pointing the alphabets, before the circling activity, I think you are mentioning that. Before circling activity is that first we have to teach them alphabets. That's what I have been saying. Teach the alphabets from the outside. Teach them from outside, not from the books. Teach them wherever they see an object. If you are having some grocery packs, you are having the Kellogg's, you are having cornflakes, show them. This is C. They can remember it very well. Then move on to the books actually. Yeah. Okay. So next, give time for self-correction also to kids. Most of the times, we parents, we just go inside and say, no, this is that, that is this, you are saying this, you are saying that. Give them time. If they are not saying anything correctly, just wait for a minute or just say them, can you please check this again? Can you please see this again? So that kid has a time to self-correct. We don't give that time. We are in a rush. No, you have done it wrongly. Just point that, but don't say it is wrong or anything. Give them the time to self-correct. That is very important, not for smaller kids, for anyone, for this matter. For bigger kids also, give them the time to self-correct themselves. Yeah. For little bigger kids, then I'm mentioning this age, like around 8 years of this age group or these kids. They already like know many things. They play and their attention span differs. They are actually in the next stage. They are bigger kids. So for these kids and all, if you are giving any instructions, if you are giving some instructions, ask the kid to paraphrase those instructions in their own language. If you are saying them, today we are going to do science homework and you have to finish this lesson. And I will always suggest whenever you are working with a kid, whenever you are doing some homework time or anything with your kid, first let them know what you are expecting from the kid. We think in our mind our kid will finish English homework, then max homework, then no, first explain to the kid, today English homework. This is for little bigger kids where the kid can actually understand. This is now our time is English homework time and we are going to finish 5 fill-ups and 5 match the following or anything of the sort. So you are explaining them and whenever you give an instruction, ask the kid to rephrase, paraphrase the same thing in their own language and let them know so that you can understand how much your child has actually listened to it or how much actually they have grabbed from our information. So this is very important when you are handling a little bigger kids. Then as soon as I say bigger kids, the main thing now and usually after this pandemic or any time is their homework time. Homework time is like the biggest time where we want our kids to write, to do the homework, to have complete the homework. And we sometimes become anxious if our kid doesn't complete it. Oh, my kid didn't write. They were not at all focusing. They didn't concentrate today. Tomorrow, they won't wake up in the morning. Or tomorrow, they have to get up and class would already start that time. So, we have to make them finish it. How to make this homework time? Someone also has asked me. So, for this is for like little bigger kids, for the homework time, how to make them focus, everything. Whenever you are choosing your kid to do homework, choose a place where the table is completely empty. At least a part of the table should be empty. Please don't keep all the things over the table and ask the kid, don't see that side, just focus here. Kids won't be that way. If there is something, they want to take it. They want to just play it. They want to fidget it. So try possibly a empty table for them. If they are sitting and writing in a desk, the normal desk, try keeping the desk completely empty so that first we are actually clearing whatever things where their attention would be grabbed. If possible, make them sit in a separate room so that they can focus a lot and they can focus more also. There won't be any sounds or disturbances. If it is not possible, not a separate room, that is not possible for them. Yes, Manisha, this happens, correct. So if that is not possible for them, you can choose a room, a hall or a bedroom or any other room, and make the kid to see the wall. The kid should see the wall. It's not the way like kid should be seeing the other way. Kid should be focusing on the wall. They should see the wall and you sit in the opposite way to the kid. So we are reducing the distractions. First point. Kid is only facing the wall and they can't see for longer time. It's like an empty wall or anything. They would be more attentive also. They can focus on the homework. Then give them breaks. Like I said, as I said in the beginning of the session, decide your age of the kid and then plan like how much time they can actually sit for an activity. If your kid is 5 years, 15 minutes is their attention span. 20 minutes, around 20 minutes activities can be planned. So keep everything ready for them when they are starting itself. You can ask your kid also to get those things and plan and keep everything ready. Then start their homework time. So plan activities only for that 20 minutes. Then give a break. Ask the kid to go run around the home for 3 times. Go play with your sister for 5 minutes. Or go catch a, take a snack. Or do something. Just give them a break. They have to physically move from that place. And don't give a screen time in that gaps. Please don't do that. Because again the kid will focus towards the screen. Give them a physical activity. Just go around. Go run around. Or ask them to jump 10 times. Clap 10 times or do something. They have to move. They can do this simple brain yoga where they actually do activities and anything you can give so that there is a change for them and again they can focus back into the activity. Then you can start giving them timed activities. You have to say your kid, you can actually show them the clock or our mobile where we fix our alarm timings. 15 minutes. So till 15 minutes you have to finish the activity, then only you can go. Why I'm mentioning this is, we mostly say that after you finish this activity, you can go out and play. After you finish this activity, you can watch your favorite cartoon. So what the kid does, they'll start writing very fastly. Sometimes they don't listen or sometimes they can write legibly also. Sometimes they don't do. This is for little bigger kids also, like 10, 11 year kids also. Give them a time frame and you will let them know they have to be there continuously for 15 minutes. If the kid finishes that homework also, they will be sitting over there only. So that kid knows, actually, I have to sit here. They will start doing also. They also know that only 15 minutes. After that, my mama is going to give me a break. So let me do the homework also. So start this timed activities. You can start with a lesser time. First 10 minutes, then increase to 12, 14, 16. Kind of gradually improve the timing also. The timed activities, that's what I'm meaning. If it is a longer assignment, if it is like 3 pages homework or something, break that. Break that whenever possible. Give them in that time limit how much they can do it. And also remember the first itself I told like the timings, make them when they are interested, focus them on an activity for them. One more main thing is don't give them multiple instructions. Give one instruction at a time. You have to write this. This is your work. And just 1 minute, you have to write this. Or just one instruction at a time. That is very, very important. After they finish that question, probably give another instruction. But don't bombard them initially itself with multiple instructions so that the kid doesn't start the work itself. If for smaller kids, how to give instructions? It will be difficult for them to read as such. They find it difficult. For smaller kids, they won't be. Give them instructions in a drawing. You could just draw simply by yourself if you're planning. Just put the picture of your kid or just a stick man. You have to sit, finish English homework, some drawing, and then you go and play. Those are 3-step instructions. You stick it or you just give it to your kid. So that the kid knows, I have to start, I have to sit down, I have to complete this homework and go out. So it is an instruction in a drawing form. Visual form is very, very easy for the kids to grasp also. They understand better also. Suppose your kid is little fidgety, they want to play with an eraser or a pencil. If it is very mild and that is not disturbing their concentration or attention, just leave it. Most of the times we used to say, no, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. Actually, we are focusing on the eraser longer than actually the kid. It's okay if they are mild fidgety. If they are like completely playing, it's a different thing. If they are like very mild and they just want to fiddle around, they want to just move the things around, it's okay, leave it. Let them focus. If they are focusing on the task, that is very good and well done. When the kid is reading books, if the kid is reading some book or something, it's okay if the little bigger kids, if they want to move around, they want to go around also, let them go around, let them walk and also read. Yes, just a second. So, I was saying the reading strategies. If the kid wants to read, if they want to read and move, that's okay. Teach for little bigger kids how to walk and read without hitting on anything. Give them a space in the room or space in their hall or a balcony. They can actually walk and read so that they are moving a little and they are also reading. Or if you are only going to tell them or teach them, that's okay. They can walk around the room and you will be giving them instructions also. So that the kid focuses more. They want to move around. They want to do some activities. So that is how we try to grab the attention of smaller kids. Next is for big kids, like for 10-year kids, I will say like teach them to plan the activities by themselves. That is very important. Like they understand that they have to pay attention for this long. They know this activity will take this long also. You could start teaching them to plan activities from 7 years itself. You could have a small planner. You can ask your kid to write or you can write for them. These are the homeworks. You can actually have like works to be completed, works completed column, so that kid itself knows these are the works. I have these tasks. I have to complete these tasks. We as adults do this planning. Why not start from that age itself? They itself learn, and the main thing, as I always say, is kids should learn. They have to do, they have to pay attention for that activity. That will build once they know these are the activities for me. So I have to complete 5 homeworks, or not homework, anything, any book or anything. I have to complete these many tasks. So when will I complete? These are the works to be completed and this is that. So this is how you give them ideas to start their own planner from 7 years. You could start with the daily planners. So these are few activities which we can do for kids for improving their attention, for actually to focus more on being there attentive. And we build these attention skills one at a time, like it's a building blocks. Just straight away don't make your kid like they have to focus for 2 hours. They have to sit there, they have to listen to it completely. For bigger kids, if they are reading by themselves, after 20 minutes or 25 minutes, ask the kid stop whatever they have read. Ask them to tell what they have read to any one of the person in the home. Any one person. They have to just repeat it. If to their sibling or to a parent or to a grandparent, they have to repeat what they have read. So that again after that, they can again go back and read. More than 20 to 25 minutes, it's difficult for them to be fully attentive to that situation and read it or grasp it. So after that, they can actually go out and tell the home. So this is useful for little bigger kids. These are all for the kids. For some kids, there will be attention deficit. They can have some issues with their attention. For some kids, they will be little hyperactive. For some kids, their attention will be little less. They will be more impulsive. They will be hyperactive. They won't be listening to us. So, what should we do for these kids? At home, I am explaining tips only at home. Try to break down their assignments as much as possible. Try splitting their assignments into smaller chunks or smaller parts. Then, praise your child. Not for only these kids, for everyone. Praise your child and praise in every single step. Don't expect the final outcome. Once you complete the homework only, I'll praise. That is not the correct. Praise them even if your kid sits and does the activity for 2 minutes, or if they are able to complete that activity, or they are able to write it in a complete sentence. Yes, praise that what they have done. So the kid knows that yes, they have that interest to complete it and proceed it. Then for these kids, try to use signals. Their attention is already little difficult, so try using signals. Most of the times we get tired saying telling the same again repeated. No, don't run, sit, because you are using your whole energy and the kid's energy is also being getting wasted. So if you are saying sit, there should be some common signal. If you are showing some signal for the kid, they should sit. Yes, the kid will sit. Then you can start the activity. Then keep everything ready for the kid, because and directly jump into the task. Don't start with other activities and then finally go into it. Jump into the task immediately. This is what you are going to do and this is the whole set of instructions, and you just start with them so that their attention is still with you. Teacher mindfulness exercises. You can model them how to be mindful of things, how to breathe, everything for the kids so that their attention is still focused. They are listening to you more. You could actually do attention activities in daily simple routines. Don't give them a separate time for attention activities. Just include them in a regular activity. For smaller kids, it starts with toys. Then it goes to the books and it changes as their age proceeds. So these are all the activities for attention. Attention is very, very important, and the main thing is sustained attention for them to do an activity continuously for a stretch of time. That is what we are focusing at. So do try these activities, all these activities with your kids at home. I will be trying to answer questions as and when possible. You could give me in comments also. If there are any other questions, do let me know now so that I could be answering it for attention skills. Or you can again also you could put in your comments so that I will know what other difficulties or how you want your kids to actually learn more and be more attentive. Yes. Okay. I think I'm getting comments also. Thank you. Okay. So thank you all for being a wonderful audience and being with me for this whole session. And thank you, Mrs. Asta Jain, for giving me this opportunity to talk on this platform. Thank you all, and I want to end my session with a small phrase, small mantra. So this is what I wanted to show. It is like be here now. It is a simple thing. Be here now. Just be there, whether it can be for your child or for you or for anyone. Just be there at the moment. Just for the kid also, if they are doing homework or anything, just let them know you have to be here at this moment. Let them focus it. For smaller kids, just put a poster or something or write and stick it also on the wall. Be here now. For 10-15 minutes or any activity, they have to be here. That is what is all about this mindfulness or attention, concentration, focus on activities. So Preeti is asking for some activities for 6-year kids. Yeah, for 6-year kids, the activities, as I mentioned, that alphabet activity is very good. In a book, take a text, their storybook or something. In a book, ask them to find out the letters wherever T is there. Or you could start with the color. If there is some small bird or something, wherever that yellow bird is there, give them that. You could actually buy books for them where there are puzzles and riddles for them so that they can sit and do it for a longer period of time, and they will be focusing only on the puzzle for a longer time. They will be concentrating completely. If it is their favorite puzzle or their favorite, if the kid is interested with the toys like cars, Hot Wheels, if a 7-year-old kid is interested into that, buy or make some own puzzles with that favorite toys, and then give them a puzzles. Puzzles will start around this age. Brain games, what we say, to engage them more, that is very, very good for 7-year-old kids. letters, they will be more interested in the alphabets, letters and colors. Engage them in those kind of activities to build their attention span. As I said, you could also do that crossword games. You could start teaching the crossword games. And for the auditory attention activities, teach them all these games, kind of anagram games, where you say a word, mad, they have to change it and say to you, damn. Or any other games involving alphabets, because those kids are very curious, they know to recognize all these alphabets and they want to build it more. They can be focusing on that. Then give them time to play outside, if possible, not now, if possible afterwards. Give them time as much as possible to play them outside. You could start with the formal games, formal sports for them around 7 years. That will improve their concentration and attention. It's a must task for a bigger kid because they have lots of energy inside them. You could start with a formal game, whichever they are interested. Those are all for attention activities only. I think I got like 7 year old and 11 year old. Yes, for a 7 year and 11 year old, you could give activities both their age groups. You could give a simple activity which the 7 year old can do. For 11 year old, just give a little modification for them. Suppose, as I said, you're giving them a crossword game. For the 11 year old, should write the spellings also correctly with that. They should be filling it up for a smaller kid. They should write the spellings also. That way they can actually sit and do. Books where the odd man out game books. You would have heard of it. Odd man, there will be multiple pictures, like around 20 to 30 pictures. And one picture will be changed. They have to find which one, which image is changed for them. Which one is changed? Which one is looking in the right side? Which one is looking in the upside form in those 30 pictures? We have those kind of worksheets also coming out. So those worksheets are very, very helpful. You could start that with all age group kids and give them the puzzles, the board games. Those are all very useful for 7, 11 because as I said, they like letters. They like to play with alphabets more. Give them games like Scrabble, all these board games where they actually do calculations and they also play it for a longer period of time. If you're playing a business game, the kid will obviously sit there for a longer period of time rather than any other online or any YouTube or anything. Kid will actually sit there for a longer period if you're playing a board game. And as I said, if possible, always try to have activities as a whole family so that they will be always interested to do it. You can ask them to be write your list for the family. They can actually write it. They can ask everyone and write it. They are listening to it and they have to write it down. Those are all simple activities, but we can make that so that they can be more attentive also. Thank you all. Thank you all so much for being a wonderful audience. Thank you, Mrs. Asta Jain. Thank you all from Mrs. Diva's group also. See you all again on our next session. Take care.